Hi everyone. So hope you all are safe at home. Hamo ge wale dola parasmin inna kile hitema. Right. Can you think of something that you did yesterday? Iye karbu deyak gana hitanna puluwanda? Think. Ah, mage in my case mage widere balawa mama gedara hitiya. Mama gedara hitiya. So what is this verb here? Metana dena kriya mokadda? Hitiya, right. So inna what is it in English? Stay. So, now I will show you three sentences. Like, look at this. I stay at home. I am staying at home. And the new one, I stayed at home. Then, what is it? Mama gedara hitiya mokada mama ehuwa wagen den karana deyak den kara kara inna deyak wat oya puruddak washin karana deyak ganak tad neme mama ehuwe I ask you mama ehuwa yagen I ask you what you did yesterday iye kale monada kiyala ehuwe I was not asking about your habits or what are you doing now right okay now see look at this sentence right I stay at home did you recall my video lesson, my previous lesson, my kalin video padam gana matak karoth. So it was about simple present tense, and now you will see that this sentence is in simple present tense. Me wakye di na simple present tense. Man kohomath kiyanne balanna ko me. Look at the subject verb. Onam ekak thiyena subject verb widene na. Look at the way the verb is. Verb ekak thiyena widiye balanna. Verb is in best form. So I have taught you man kiyala thiyena I kiyanne plural verb word ekak English so. I stay. So I stay at home. If you renew this, make alut karo. If I say I stay at, if I'm going to modify this sentence, one make a vinas karanna yani. I stay at home every Sunday. Anna mama kena mama hama iridama make a thadiya dik karna. Mama hama iridama gedarina. Now see, here you are talking about a habit, then it is okay. Kahari. හැබැයි දැන් මේක මම අහ ප්‍රශ්නෙට ගැලපෙනවද නැහැ මම ඇහුවේ ඔයා ඊයේ කළේ මොකද්ද කියලා. So මම ඊයේ කරපකට I stay at home කිව්වොත් වැරදි. This is wrong. This is wrong. මේක වැරදි. Did you understand? I stay at home කියන්නේ මේ මොකක් හරි මගේ පුරුද්දක්. This is one of my habits or one of my regular activities. මොකක් හරි දෙයක් ගැන තමයි මේ කියන්නේ. එහෙනම් මම ඊයේ කරපු කරලා ඉවරච්ච දෙයක් ගැන නෙමෙයි කතා කරන්නේ. So I am staying at home. Make a kiyanu pulada mangi prashna man hoy I asked you what you did yesterday iye monada kale kiyala hoy enam eka if you say I am staying at home what is this tense this is present continuous tense if you want you can again go to that video and watch it I wanna nan e padamata gihila balanna puluwa so I am staying continuous am staying the present continuous so there I taught you present continuous tense is used to talk about actions happening now or these days me den hari me dawasala min thina actions gana katha karanne present continuous tense so this sentence is written in present continuous tense I asked you then karana deyak gana nemen man hari mama ehuwe what did you do yesterday iye karapu deyak karala iwara vicha deyak gana man me ahana I am talking about something already finished එහෙනම් ඒකට I am staying at home කියලා උත්තර දුන්නොත් again wrong did you understand එහෙනම් so this is in simple present tense this is in present continuous tense I asked you what you did yesterday ඊයේ කරපු දෙයක් ගැන හෙව්වේ එහෙනම් මේ විදිහට උත්තර දෙලත් වැරදි මේ විදිහට උත්තර දෙලත් වැරදි so this is the correct way this is the correct way I stayed at home I stayed at home. So look at this. I stayed. See? First you have the subject. Mulima kriyava karana kena inna. Then me again. Stay is a verb. Am staying is the verb. Methana stayed. Do you see? What is this? Methana tiyenne me balanna. Stay kiyanne innawa. Stayed. Hitiya. So when if you want to talk about finished actions. Karala ivaram actions kriya gana katha karana ona. Then there we use simple past sentence. We use simple past tense to talk about finished actions. Karla ivarama deval gan katha karanna api simple past tense katha karanna use karana. So that is the use of simple past tense. Okay, right. See, look at these examples. Praveen watched a film. We grew vegetables. I cleaned my room. So all these three sentences are in simple past tense. අපි එක හොයාගන්නේ by looking at the verb. You can identify that by looking at the verb. Verb එක දිහා බලද්දි මෙයා simple past tense කියලා අපි හොයාගන්න. බලන්නකො. All these verbs are in the past form. ක්‍රියාපදයේ අතීත කාලෙම ඉන්නේ. See? Watched කියන්නේ බැලුවා, නැරඹුවා. Grew කියන්නේ වැව්වා, වවනවා, grow, වැව්වා, grew. Clean පිරිසිදු කරනවා, cleaned පිරිසිදු කළා. Now, if you recall my lesson again on verbs, verbs can part of my venam kara, right? In those, we learned that. So, this is called the base form. May verb be grabbed mulika karya kila kino. Because may I padanam karya kino, may say ram hadan. This is called the base form because we make all these by using this. See, go, S form is goes, ing is going, goes past tense, as it past form went, yanama gya, and the past participle is gone, gihilla. And also we learnt again that there are two types of verbs, regular, irregular. I mean, regular, irregular verbs can hold it then and in one when you are using simple, learning simple past tense. Simple past tense can khata karat di, regular, irregular verbs, when you are talking, regular, irregular verbs can hold it then and in one. So, see, can you remember? So, heat rat karana, heated rat kala, heated again past participle rat karala. The sun washed, so the nama, washed, sedua, this washed, so the la. Eat kanama, ate kayava, eaten kala. Cut, cut, cut. May cut base form is what? Kapanama. This cut, kapa, kapua. This cut, past participle cut, kapala. So we learn that in regular verbs, the difference is in regular verbs, you make the past tense by adding ed. Did you understand? Right. So this metana pattern ekak tiyena. There is a pattern here. You make the past tense of those verbs by adding ed. Here, there is no such pattern. Ed add karana ge pattern ekak na. E nisa thama api meyata ratawak tiyena nisa regular verbs kiyena. This we call irregular verbs. If you want more information about this, you can watch my video on these verbs. Right? Okay. So now again, back to this. Look at this again. Now see, Praveen watched. What's at the beginning? Subject. Kriyava karma kiyana me. Kawuda wewe api. So first you write what? You write the subject. Then verb. Kriyava. Now look at this. This verb is in what form? Past form. It was like you can add anything you want. Before we wind up another example. Mata kiyanna ona. And the other thing. Now in this one, remember. Now, simple present tense, present continuous වල නම් subject එක singular plural වෙද්දි මොකද වෙන්නේ? Verb එක වෙනස් වෙනවා. But remember, in simple present tense and present continuous, the verb changed according to the subject. If it is singular, the verb was different. If it is plural, the verb form was different. But in past tenses, there is no such thing. Past tenses වල එහෙම දෙයක් නැහැ. Even though the subject is singular or plural, the verb remains the same. Singular, plural, una kiyala mansanne verb ekak dekatama ek vidihakata thamai thiyenne. Right. Now, before we wind up another sentence, I want to tell, Kamala, right, giya satiye, match, tarangaya dinnwa. Api kiyamu, gayana tarangaya dinnwa. Kamala giya satiye gayana tarangaya dinna. Now this is a finished action. Meka ivara vich kriyawa karala me vacha wakya. Ehenam you had to use simple past tense. Now think about the structure of simple past tense. Simple past tense liyena vidiya gana hitanna. Subject. Then kawuda dinne? Kamala. Kamala karapu verb ekak mokadda? Dinuwa. So dinanawa in English is win. The past form of win is won. So Kamala won. What did she win? Mokadda dinne? The singing competition. When did she win? Kawadda dinne? Last Monday. Last week. So Kamala won the singing competition last week. So that is it. So you need simple past tense when you are talking about finished actions. So thank you so much. please share, do us a favor by subscribing to our YouTube channel, Clove English Academy, and also follow us on our Facebook page, Clove English Academy. And please don't think twice to share this. Because I believe, this is very much beneficial for those who are staying at home these days, especially for students who are not going to school these days because these things they need in their school syllabus and exams and everything. So ඉතින් දෙපාරක් හිතනවා මේක තව කෙනෙක් එක්ක බෙදා ගන්න. මොකද ගෙදර ඉඳන් මේ දේ ඉගෙන ගන්නක විශේෂයෙන් වැදගත් වෙනවා. විශේෂයෙන් මේ දවස්වල ගෙදර ඉන්න දරුවන්ට යන ඩිස්කෝල යන විදිහකුත් නැහැ. So watching something like this much will be much interesting for this for them. මේ වගේ දේවල් බලන්න කියලා ගොඩක් ආස හිතෙන දේක්. So help them and be with us. Thank you so much.